believe that if you do so, there's every indication that jobs will be created and sustainable livelihood of mining communities will be assured. Then we can think about eradicating or removing or reducing illegal and irresponsible mining, which normally will result in poverty alleviation and wealth creation. This is very difficult to look at. Pardon me. I'll take one segment. The green you see there are the challenges. And the blue, or the deeper blue, is the solutions. And then the cross-cutting solutions. So if you take mercury and cyanide pollution, for instance, which is a problem, which is a challenge, erosion and deforestation, the solution will be a collective environmental impact assessment, promoting awareness, and so on and so forth, and so on. Technological innovation. But the cross-cutting will be improved data collection and research, better provision of demand-oriented services. So you see that environmental issues come into play in a new approach, networks and knowledge and policy, economic and markets, governance and formalization, and social issues. These are all supposed to be looked at holistically so that we can get the answers, we can get the solutions to work. I keep telling people that the solutions to this galamsey issue does not lie with the Minerals Commission, does not even lie with the Ministry of Lands and Natural Resources, not even the INSEM. It lies with you who are consultants and experts who we need to come and help us provide solutions. It lies with the community themselves. It lies with the small-scale miners themselves. That's one I don't have. I think that it's good that I'm not a mining expert, because I then begin to depend rather on those experts rather than think that I know it. I don't know anything about mining. I know my field, but it's been good trying to work with people who know. So keep yourself readiness.